A fire in Manchester apartment building sent 8 families running out onto the street early this morning. Fire alarms started going off around 2:30 in the morning, and smoke filled the front entrance of 558 Silver Street. Everyone was able to get out safely, but as Heather Hamill reports, it has many people about what's worried about what's coming next. She has our top story.
No one is allowed back in the building, and that leaves 28 people displaced and wondering what to do next.
It was 2:30 in the morning when fire ripped through this Silver Street apartment building.
Came to the back porch over here, opened the door, and the guy from the next door apartment from us said to get out of the building. The building's on fire, and he said, "I don't know where it's coming from. Get him out."
Nicole Emmons lives in apartment 2 with her boyfriend and 2 kids, as well as her sister and her 2 kids. They spent the night at their parents' place, but they have no room for all of them, and they aren't allowed back in the building. The landlord, Mohammed Mobeen, was at the apartment this afternoon talking with his tenants.
It definitely do break my heart, and, you know, in the middle of the night, and when you have to move from your home, get out, fire, you know, fire is a very devastating for everybody.
Mobeen says he owns other buildings and is trying to move some of the people there. Fire officials still haven't determined if this fire is suspicious, but they say it did start in the center of the common cellar and quickly moved up to the second floor.
In between the walls, so they went in apartment 4 and took all her ceilings down, her walls down. She's got nothing left. Absolutely nothing.
As for Nicole, she will stay at a hotel for a couple of nights and is staying strong for her kids.
I'm so tired. I'm just exhausted. I haven't slept since 2:30 this morning. I've been up, and I couldn't go back to sleep, and I can't go back to sleep now because of kids. But I'm just trying to hang in there and just see where we go from here.
The Red Cross has helped some of the families with clothing and the basic necessities, and Nicole says that she'll be meeting with them a little later on this evening. Now, the fire department says they still do not know a cause, but they will be investigating again tomorrow. Reporting in the newsroom, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.